Robin Radar Systems provide you with a complete overview of bird and drone activity on and around your aerodrome. Our bird radars provide you with the actionable information you need to take control of your bird hazard issue. With both tactical and strategic data on offer, you'll be able to mitigate and prevent high-risk bird activity more accurately and with less effort than before. Increase safety while reducing bird strike incidents and expensive claims. Our drone detection systems enable you to take early control of drone hazards as they develop. Coordinate drone incidents with confidence and share clear and accurate threat location information with law enforcement agencies and other stakeholders. Reduce costly disruption and delays while increasing safety and security. Subscription-based pricing options available. Get in touch with us to find out more.
Solution to the FOD problem, AFOD is an electro-optical detection system supported with artificial intelligence, which is built to prevent the damage to airplanes and airports caused by foreign objects. Thoroughly inspecting airport runways, AFOD provides a constant flow of images and information to a central unit located at the control tower to be further processed by advanced AFOD algorithms. AFOD serves four main functions. By continuously inspecting airport runways, it detects FOD, specifying their location, size, number, and type of material. It also identifies wildlife presence, providing information as detailed as the species of the animal detected. It detects cracks and accumulation areas. It measures the depth of snow and thickness of ice.
Moog, we understand how costly foreign object debris can be, which is why we offer the Tarsier Automatic Runway FOD Detection System. In the 11 years since Tarsier was created, it has helped ensure 6 million plus FOD-free operations. It's the United States military's system of choice for FOD detection, and it can function in any and all weather conditions. The difference between Tarsier and manual FOD inspections is easy to see. Tarsier has proven that it detects all the FOD all the time, while manual inspections may miss items due to lighting conditions or the speed of a vehicle inspection. For over 65 years, Moog has been servicing the aircraft industry with innovative products and solutions. With the Tarsier Runway FOD Detection System, we're providing a solution that can generate revenue for your airport, prevent costly airport damage and lawsuits, and improve safety. Contact us.
Thank you. Good afternoon and welcome to today's second session from the FOD Drone and Habitat and Safety sessions. The second of today's sessions. If you were in the one earlier this afternoon, then welcome back. Today's session is on works management. Our speakers today are Gael Le Bris, Bryan Thompson, and Oliver Scigel. And if you want to ask them a question about their presentation, please just use the stage chat on the right of your screen, and we will aim to respond to all your questions. If not today, if there's too many, then we'll get back to you with our. You can also communicate in private or public groups of up to six people using the front row networking tool, which you can see at the bottom right of your screen. Our first up today is Gael Le Bris, who's going to talk to us about the planning and management of works. Gael is a senior aviation planner and senior technical principal with WSP USA and holds two master's degrees. He supervises aviation system and airport planning projects and provides expertise in engineering, operations and safety in the United States and abroad. Prior to joining WSP, Gael was the airside development manager at Paris-Charles de Gaulle International Airport. He's a committee member of the Airport Consultants Council, SAE International, the French-speaking airports, UAF and FA, and the Transportation Research Board. He has authored over 50 articles and publications, and he recently was the principal investigator for the ACRP Research Report 236, Prepare Your Airport for Electric Aircraft and Hydrogen Technologies. Over to you, Gael.
Thank you, John. Can you hear me?
Yep.
Excellent. Hello, everyone. Let's take a moment to talk about how we can enhance operational safety and resilience through the planning and coordination of construction works. And all of that starts with two safety events that occurred in the early and late years 2000 that you might be aware of, at least the first one. In Taipei 2000, you have Boeing 747 taking off during what we could call an adverse weather event, a typhoon literally passing over the island, very low visibility, awful weather conditions. And there you have two parallel runways, the inner runway being actually used either as a runway or taxiway, depending on the period of the year. And they were doing maintenance on that wide taxiway. And unfortunately, the 747 mistakenly aligned the inner runway / taxiway that was in maintenance, accelerated, collided with the construction equipment. And you might know the rest of the story. Second event at Paris CDG, my former airport, in 2008. At that time, one of the runway was shortened for a construction purpose. And you have a 737 aligning the runway. The air traffic controller confirms with the phraseology that the runway is shortened. The captain confirmed that he's aware of that, but actually they took off with aircraft performance based and computed based on the full runway length. And as you see on the picture, the aircraft collided with the plastic delineators fortunately, they avoided the jet blast fences that you see in the background that are totally non-fungible. What we learn through these two accidents as an aviation community is that you can publish all the NOTAMs and supplement AIP that you want. It's not necessarily enough for ensuring an adequate level of safety that is going to prevent that kind of incidents and accidents. And these are two examples of a very long list of safety events that can occur during construction. And you see this, what you see right now on the screen is just a short selection of runway safety events only. It's not only, not even listing safety events during taxiway or apron construction. So you see that it's still an issue. And what we've done as an industry, as an aviation, as a community of aviation professionals, is when we collectively became aware of that situation, the fact that we were lagging behind in terms of practices during airfield construction works, is to work together in order to develop new practices in order to fix that gap in terms of information and coordination, not only in real time, but also ahead of the game, you know, in terms of strategic coordination and planning of programs and projects that can have an impact on airfield operations. And we're going to focus on that right now. And most of the practices that I'm going to share with you through the coming slides, they came from all of these discussions, research efforts, and so on, that were conducted from the mid-2010 until now. And some of them are actually available in guidance materials, documents from ICAO, ACI, and so on that I will mention when relevant. Okay, and again, here we are talking about planning and coordination. So not necessarily real-time operational safety, but how you can prevent incidents that can have an impact on aviation safety, but also leading to a loss of airfield capacity and resilience. And one of the secret to that is collaboration and anticipation. And most of the practices I'm going to mention right now, they are available with templates and guidance through ACRP Research Report 229 on airport collaborative decision making. And this is a set of materials that is available for free on the website of the US Transportation Research Board. You can Google it, will be the first link that is going to pop up. And how can you implement a set of processes that is going to make sure that there is no gap, no dark zones that are not covered in terms of coordination and safety. Talking about what we've done at my former airport, Paris Charles de Gaulle, when I was there, we had a multi-layered approach that I developed with my colleagues when we started a massive capital improvement program back in 2011. And what we came up is with, number one, a meeting and a task force that was meeting every 2 or 3 months, that the only purpose of that group was to talk about strategic coordination of projects and programs that can have any kind of impact on airfield operations and safety. And the kind of people that were attending this call or meeting, myself, of course, as an airside development manager at that time, all the projects program managers, but also people from the air traffic control tower, airline representatives, and so on. And what we were doing is that we were trying to strategically deconflict all of these different construction operations at 6 months to 1 year ahead of the game. Okay, we were looking at plus 6 months, 12 months, and we were trying to deconflict when we were realizing that simultaneous construction projects could adversely impact safety and capacity. And what we were doing is that every time we were revising that grand plan, we were issuing a new version of this bulletin of the airside works that is not for operational purpose, it's for situational awareness of the aviation community ahead of the NOTAMs and so on. And you see that here, week by week, you have a depiction of all these construction operations, but also major operational changes that can have also an impact and that you have to take into consideration. For instance, a change in the taxiway designation or interruption of ILS services because they are doing maintenance. All these kind of things were, and are still actually, they're still doing that at my former airport, mentioned in that booklet that again, was refreshed every 2 or 3 months or every time we were changing dates in terms of construction operation. Okay, and then that's not the end of the story. It's just the beginning, because then after we were having, and they're still doing, weekly coordination meetings for construction coordination purpose. And here you have a construction coordinator from the airport operator, and you have all the construction supervisors. They must attend this meeting in order to get cleared to close a section of the apron and make a change to the operating conditions at some point. And you have air traffic controllers and airline representatives as well. And the goal is to, from the booklet, to check if the weekly requests from the construction supervisors are consistent with the grand plan. If not, assessing with the ATC and so on, if it's possible to tweak the plan and to confirm the airfield closures for the next week. And from that, and again, that template is available in that toolbox I was mentioning earlier. What you can do is to have that spreadsheet that itemizes all the airfield closures one by one, or all the temporary changes to the operating conditions with contact information of the construction supervisors, the NOTAMs, if applicable, and so on. And the goal of that spreadsheet is to share the information across the stakeholders, okay? Again, it's not because you issue a NOTAM that everyone is going to be aware of that. I remember a pilot, for instance, telling me that for a flight to Paris to Mumbai, he had 600 NOTAMs to review, okay? So things can get lost, you know, at the middle of all of that. But with that spreadsheet, you can increase awareness to the flight operators, for instance, on specific issues, and then they might check the NOTAM or AIP supplement and then tell to their flight information department, hey guys, we need to really highlight that piece of information because we're talking about something critical like declared distances or things like that, you know. And that spreadsheet, then it's something that you should update on the daily basis. Because yes, the construction supervisors got clearance for the next week, but then after maybe on Monday, they're going to realize that they are missing an equipment or someone is sick and they have to make change to their plan and they're going to request an adjustment of the airfield closure that they need. And of course, you need to update that spreadsheet and convey that to the community of operations. So again, the goal is to have something holistic, like we say these days, comprehensive, that do not leave any hole in the net in order to make sure that all these construction operations are coordinated, that the safety and capacity aspects are taken into consideration, and that all the stakeholders are aware of that. And maybe you need also you know, along with these coordination meetings and working groups and so on, do a bit of education, especially when, for instance, your airline rep is changing. Maybe it comes from another department of the airlines and you need to raise awareness specifically to that person about the specificities of your airport, specificities of airfield construction and so on. The same way, construction supervisors, you cannot expect them to be aviation operations expert. It's not their job. And the same way, you have to learn about their expectations, their needs, and so on. And one way to do that is to, again, educate about the process, aviation-specific processes and so on. And for instance, one of the items that is not necessarily well known from the construction world is everything about aeronautical information. Why is it so critical? And what you see right now on the screen is a quick reference sheet that is available in that ACDM toolbox from ACRP that you can use for educating your airside and construction operations community about all of these aspects. And construction supervisor might not understand why, for instance, you cannot let it go that it cannot just change 1 week ahead the date of the runway closure or the runway shortening because the air crews are not going to be aware of it because of the airac cycles, because of the regular updates of Jepsen, Lido, and so on. a NOTAM that is issued last minute is just going to pop up on the iPad in the cockpit, but it's not necessarily going to be a yellow sheet or an airline-specific page that is going to provide them all the information and the level of awareness they are supposed to get on something that critical, that a runway closure or a change in the a temporarily shortened runway or these kind of things. Okay, so education is very important, and when I say education, it's a noble definition of education. It's good to educate people. You cannot know everything, so it's good to educate others about the needs of the airfield operations, but also in return to educate yourself about the constraints of the construction projects and so on, in order to find something, some sort of middle ground, without, of course, endangering safety and capacity. And what's very important, what I learned as a former airport operator, is also to listen success stories and lessons learned from other airports. And again, in the toolbox that I'm mentioning from ACRP, we have stories from CDG, O'Hare, and others on successful capital improvement programs, successful from a safety and capacity standpoint, because again, a lot of coordination, a lot of mutual understanding, and a lot of discussions, informations, and so on, in order to raise awareness. Okay, something else is about how to reach out to people, especially in real time, right? And sometimes you are an airport operations manager, you know that something is happening with a construction site, and you don't know who to contact. So something you can do is actually to have these contact sheets with the name of the key airport operations people that you can share with the construction supervisors in order to have shared points of contact, you know, across, again, the community of the operations people, both construction operations and airfield / airport operations. Okay, and then I'm not going to spend too much time talking about real-time operational safety, but when you did strategic coordination of airport projects and programs, when you did pre-tactical and tactical coordination of construction operations, is still not the end of the story, because then you have to make sure that all the information, in particular the visual information to the air crews, is in place in the field, and that it's efficient. And just for your information, when you look at the advisory circulars from the FAA or the EA PPRI from Eurocontrol or other documents that are available from ACI and other organizations, you will find out that practices have tremendously evolved over the past 5 years or so. And we have developed through research projects, and when I say we, it's different groups of people from the field that I had the pleasure to be part of, we've developed innovative safety device. For instance, the kind of signs that you see here on the screen that are for information purpose. So this is, instead of having a yellow sign, you have an orange signage with specific wording that we developed with air traffic controllers and airline pilots in order to be efficient, to catch their attention on the specific safety critical changes that can be implemented in the fields, such as, for instance, here, a reduction of the takeoff run available. Same thing, be mindful when you developed an airfield safety plan to make sure that all the markings that are necessary, all the signage is in place in the field. And sometimes you need to go beyond the standards. Sometimes standards are not enough. For instance, that simplified display threshold markings for temporarily shortened runway that I marked with a red cross comes from Annex 14. And based on research I've made over the past 10 years or so, this kind of configuration, they can generate incidents and accidents because it's not conspicuous. The kind of things that you see right now on the screen, these are real construction operations. This is confusing. This is confusing, and you don't have to be a pilot to see that it's confusing. Here's a display threshold is here. Here's a display threshold is there. See, it's confusing, it's not clear. And when it's not clear, it can generate safety incidents. So be mindful, comprehensive, listen to the airline pilots, and don't forget, on top of everything I said in terms of coordination, to do a safety risk assessment, an SRA, as part of your safety management system process. And I hear you. Sometimes you can say, hey, it's a lot to do SRA for a tiny construction operation on a taxiway or on an apron. Well, you should do something. You cannot just skip it. And maybe it's not a full safety risk assessment with all the assessment matrices and so on. Maybe it's just a safety review. This is what I was doing at my former airport. When you don't have time or when it's not relevant to do a full safety risk assessment, well, maybe you do just a safety review, which is a two-hour meeting with everyone that needs to be in the room, and you just sort out all the potential safety issues, like a safety risk assessment, but without all the matrices and tables and so on, just to make sure that you're not forgetting anything about safety. Okay. And again, sometimes this information that you put in the field can be difficult to put in place practically. So again, listen to your construction crews. Hey, is it difficult to maintain painted markings or geotextiles all the time on the runway? Well, come up with something, a new safety devices. And here you see on the lower part of the screen that runway closure marker that we made in wood, with IKEA wheels, literally, and geotextiles stapled on the wood frame. And that thing doesn't fly away and can be moved with only four people, you know. And like that, you can have your closure markers all the time on the runway or on the shoulders or right along the runway pavement if you are literally redoing the full width of runway plus shoulder pavement. Okay, so in conclusion, what can you do to enhance safety and resilience through planning and coordination? Number one is to have procedures and processes agreed with all your stakeholders to ensure adequate coordination. And that can be done, for instance, as part of your discussion of your local airport collaborative decision-making, if you have a local ACDM, or you can create ad hoc something to put in place these collaborative procedures. Number two, you need to involve all the stakeholders that are impacted or that can impact operational safety and resilience, including non-traditional stakeholders that you might not think about. Someone is doing a construction works on an off-airport hotel. Yeah, but because of the height of the building, that might impact at some point your operations. These people, they need to be involved into your coordination process. Anticipate and be proactive. Promote and enforce these principles. If in your procedure is written that all construction supervisors need to be at your weekly coordination meeting and that someone skipped that meeting and that they are requesting last minute to close a piece of taxiway that is safety critical, well, I'm sorry, but they have to postpone their construction works because safety first and because capacity and delay is important as well for your airport. Make sure the information you receive and understood in the field by the construction supervisors, but also in the cockpit with the air crews. And it's why it's so important to have all of these people involved all along. You know, the local representative of your airline, of your airlines, they are not necessarily aviation operations expert, but they might be able to send the information to the right point of contact within the flight operations department of their airline that might be able to flag critical pieces of information that otherwise will be buried under a pile of NOTAMs. And share lessons learned internally, you know, at your airport, but also between airports. You know, there are good conferences, good working groups out there under the umbrella of your National Airport Association or Regional Airport Association, ACI, and so on. And these are good opportunities to share success stories, but also what went wrong in order to make sure that your colleagues don't make the same mistake, but also that you learn from their own I will not say failure, actually, because you need to learn from these things, but from bad lessons, let's say, or bad episodes. You know, it's very important to share what works, but also what went wrong with other airports and members of the aviation operations community. Okay. And that's pretty much it for me. If you have any questions, if you have trouble finding the ACRP research report 229 that I was mentioning on that, or that you are looking for further reading, please feel free to reach out to me anytime. My email address, gael.lebris@wsp.com. Thank you.
Thank you, Gael. Very interesting. Thank you very much. I'm going to ask you one question from our audience, and then I've got a couple of other questions, but we'll wait until the end to see how much time we've got, if that's okay. This question is from Ivan Kratochvil. He says, it's a great topic, Gael. Would you believe that digital data visualization, and particularly immediate digital NOTAM distribution, could prevent such accidents, I guess, as the ones you showed in your earliest slides?
That's a very good question. And the answer is yes, of course. But it's a very good question, because until a very recent past, you didn't have all of these tools. Again, you had good people from the field that decided to team up and advocate to the civil aviation authorities to develop these kind of things, including here in the United States. You know, the idea of publishing what was called visual NOTAMs, and now there is a different name, and you can find that on the aeronautical information portal of the FAA. That idea came from a coalition of air traffic managers. They created the Airport Construction Advisory Council, ACAC, and they have a very good website with a very good set of best practices if you want to search for them on internet. And they advocated to the FAA headquarters, hey, we need to come up with something more visual. And that's very helpful, of course. But now, if you want to make that mainstream, you need to implement this kind of visual NOTAMs directly in the cockpit on all these tablets and so on that air crews are equipped with now. And for that, you need to work with Jepsen, Lido, and so on in order to make sure that they convey the information that is safety critical on this kind of materials. And when I say to talk to these guys, who's the flight data providers, I literally mean that airports can find their contact information through their local flight operators, have a mailing list, and send them the kind of spreadsheet and booklets I was mentioning. That's what I was doing when I was at my working for my former airport. All the booklets and sheets that I was mentioning, I was sending that to my Jepsen, Lido, Air Data, and so on contacts in order to make sure that not missing anything.
Yes, perfect. Thank you, Gael. Next up, we have Bryan Thompson and Oliver Scigel. Bryan has been involved in the aviation industry for the past 30 years with experience running airports in Africa, India, Australia, and the United Arab Emirates, and most recently in Saudi Arabia. Bryan currently works as the executive director for airports in Neom. Neom is a future-focused city looking to transform the way we live. Neom is constructing a city, but also creating a new aviation sector. And Neom has two airports in their plans. Bryan holds an MBA from the University of South Africa and is a graduate of the Australian Institute of Company Directors and a fellow with the Australian Institute of Management. Oliver has experience from various aviation industry players such as airline operations, aerodromes, airside operations, and ANSP Training Center, which led him to NG Aviation. Here today, Oliver is focused on the digitization processes and usage of digital aeronautical data, providing guidance and lectures all around the world in the field of digitization, including Europe, Southeast Asia, and the Middle East. I'll hand over first to Bryan.
Thanks very much, John. Good evening, everyone. Nice to virtually meet you all. I think this is a great conference. I think one of the things that potentially is relevant but was left off was I started my career as a pilot, then became an air traffic controller, then moved into airports. So I think I've been on each side of the conversation that we've been having up until now. I also think it's a fantastic opportunity now that we see data becoming a real currency for airports, for airlines, for big business around the world. And the importance of keeping data accurate and flowing real time is becoming more and more important. We're in the heart of Saudi Arabia now, in the future city of Neom, and we're constructing two airports. The one airport is a brownfield airport, and we started early stakeholder engagement last week, where we got 24 people around a table to understand the construction of a new airport. Now, the ability of us to communicate effectively across all of those stakeholder groups with an understanding of a lot of us have English as a third language becomes very difficult. And it does get down to a point where you want to keep data flows accurate and meaningful in a language that everybody understands. And that's where we start to talk about the digitization of data, particularly in a brownfield airport construction, where you can populate a real-time 3D version of your airport that allows everybody to understand the exact up-to-date configuration of the airfield and what's open and what's closed. You can populate NOTAM data almost real-time, and that goes through for verification and publication to all stakeholder groups. Now, I do agree that that doesn't cross all your stakeholder groups, but it does get a large portion of them all up to speed in real time, understanding the situation so that whether you're in the cockpit, the air traffic control tower, or on the construction site, everybody knows what's coming at them in almost real time. And I do think the one problem that we still do have to solve is how the cockpit stays up to date at the same speed as the airfields. But from our perspective, we are now looking at how the future of airports will be run, and old-fashioned paper and flight strips and ticker tapes are really, while they still have a place, they don't have a place in the future of aviation. So we are looking at new ways of doing things, and using real-time data transfer between ourselves as the airport, the ANSP, as well as the contractors that are working on the airfield is really the future that we're looking at. So we've had lots of conversations with service providers. Oliver, who will be presenting later on, is one of the parties that we're talking to, and I think he'll be able to take you through some real-time examples of what we're considering as the future of how we will manage projects, particularly within Neom. So from my side, thank you very much. I think we will have questions at the end, and I'm looking forward to see if there's anything in there that I can contribute to. Good, over to you, Oliver.
Thank you very much. Today, I would like to talk about the digitization of aeronautical and aerodrome information and how the digital data can be used into real-time, real-life, and real processes. First of all, the digitization of aviation industry is not just someone's random idea. The ICAO, as a global leading aviation organization, has already recognized the need for digital transition and incorporated this need into its global air navigation plan strategy, the GAMP. GAMP is considered as an important planning tool for setting global priorities to drive the evolution of the global air navigation system. The ICAO recognized that advanced technologies in aviation require digital data and more integrated, agile, and scalable information exchange. And this digital data will play an integral role in the highly interconnected systems. The European ATM Master Plan is the agreed roadmap that connects the ATM research and development activities with the deployment of scenarios to achieve the performance objectives of the Single European Sky. It also includes an airport operator roadmap containing the aerodrome digitization processes as a part of the master plan. It was recognized that without the digitization, the current ATM systems will not be able to accommodate future traffic growth, which lead us directly to the digitization itself. So what is really the purpose of digital aeronautical data? In the scope of the aerodrome, it means a complete digitization of airport into the aerodrome digital twin, containing all crucial information and data such as runways, obstacle areas, or hotspots, but also detailed information such as surface contaminants or friction measurements. The ability to exchange the data becomes more vital every day. The fact that one single data format can be used in many different systems supports the automation processes and reduces the time and costs for all stakeholders. And nowadays, the focus is put on the dynamicity of the data. And the aeronautical information are not an exception. The dynamic data evolves in time based on periodical or ad hoc updates, but always delivering the valid information. And the ability to adapt to changes within the whole aviation industry is reliable on the information sharing. The faster the information reaches the end user, the better evaluation and adaptation actions are taken. Now, in the what format should be used to be, for the digital data to be created to really serve this purpose? The aeronautical information exchange model can be an answer. The AIXM data exchange model, initially developed by the Eurocontrol and FAA, now with the great inputs from the industry, offers a complex data model for the creation of the dynamic aeronautical data. The AIXM data are based on three main pillars: the aeronautical data, the geometry, and the temporal data. Each type of this information has a significant value as a part of a complex data. Now, based on such a complex information, a digital NOTAM concept was introduced to the world of aviation. Every day, as was said before, every day a huge number of NOTAMs are published or changed, which can lead to loss of orientation. The automation and possible visualization of operational limitations is crucial to keep the aerodrome and airspace users' situational awareness and overview and increase the safety. Now, the idea of the AIXM is to group all of this information and encode them into one single file in the standardized form, supporting the global exchange and interoperability. This is an XML file containing the AIXM 5.1 digital aeronautical data. This is the place where all informations are stored. Encoding the information into a structured data format brings up several key advantages. First of all, the code is system readable, offering new data automations, quality or data checks, or usage in different other systems. The AIXM 5.x was developed to be used for the global exchange of data. That means that the reference systems, including the time and coordinates, are in the standardized form. Now, the temporality model was specifically designed for the AIXM 5.x, and it is the key element behind the dynamic data. It enables the creation and updates of digital data in one time, in one single structure, on one spot. Full history, actual information, and also future updates are located in a single database. The metadata are data about data, which support the traceability and keeps track of every action taken on the digital data, which also significantly increases the quality overall. Now, let's say that we have the AIXM data. Where exactly can I use this data and how can it be beneficial? One of the main use cases is the digital data management. The information management itself is a very time and cost-consuming process for the aerodrome and every other stakeholder. Transition to management of a digital data offer reduced time for processing the information, starting from the originator up to the provision of this information. Yeah, you are able to receive a request for a change in the digital data in the AIXM. So you are validating the data, but also the system can be validating the data for you. And here we come to the data automations and planning. As mentioned, the system-readable data offers new state-of-the-art automations, statistics, or enhanced planning. The aerodrome safeguarding and works planning are a beautiful use case. The data in the format that is meant to be globally interchanged can be loaded and used in different other systems, such as GIS systems, ATM, airside, or airborne systems, as was said before, in the cockpit, so the information can be shared. And here we come to the information sharing. Last, but probably the most important, in the real world, the access to information is everything. With the correct and valid information at the right time, every stakeholder can enhance his performance. Either it is an aerodrome and reduce turnaround time, the ANSP to control traffic more effectively, or airline to better to plan better and more accurately, but also for the pilot and the safety for the whole aviation industry. We have clarified that the AIXM is a digital data format that is meant to be used as a data source for numerous different systems. Now, let's see how these systems could look like. For this presentation, we will describe fictitious systems, the Alpha and Bravo, where both systems are using the same London Heathrow digital aeronautical data. As we explained, the digital data contains a complex information. It depends on the system only used for the reading and working with the data on how the information are interpreted to the end user. For example, the system Alpha has only one purpose: to provide enhanced visualization and access to information for stakeholders and end users. Now, starting from the top, the visualization and overview of aerodrome obstacle areas and obstacles in the vicinity of airport, not just a coordinate in the AIP or NOTAM telling the end user where the crane is located, but a direct representation of obstacle on the interactive map, providing the exact location and height of the obstacle. A 3D visualization and adjustable view can help to keep the situational awareness and evaluate risk and hazards. A crane located directly on the final approach path represents an obstacle that must be considered and evaluated. Such a visualization significantly supports the situational overview and provides a comfort of seeing the dynamic structures that are not located in the paper charts. But we are not talking only about the obstacles. The aerodrome digital twin itself, with a direct access to information, for example, the operational status, the surface properties, offers putting away the paper charts and tables. Limitations of all kinds, such as wingspan or the aircraft type, can be directly visualized to the end user. Now, what can be really interesting is the digital NOTAM concept. The digital NOTAM as the part of the AXM, as the extension on the AXM, can be also visualized. This obstacle, this crane, is situated on the taxiway near the runways. As a result, a taxiway closure NOTAM is published on both taxiways together with the work area. Besides, the taxiways are red colored as a visualization of closure. The direct access to the NOTAM is provided to the NOTAM information. And this NOTAM information is displayed in the classic human readable format. So what are the real benefits of such a system? The system Alpha showed us one of the possible way of using the digital aeronautical data by providing the real-time information and visualization. The dynamic data evolves in time and every change is automatically synchronized and displayed and accessible by the end user or stakeholder. The single source of truth in very easy way means that all systems and users work with the same information. Everybody using the system works with the same information, the same data, with no difference. And the same information is used also in our other system, the system Bravo. The system Bravo is capable of reading and working with the same data with the London Heathrow AIXM data as the system Alpha. However, the system Bravo has a different purpose, the digital data management and planning. Now, receiving, validation, verification, provision, these are only a few processes involved in the data and information management as a whole. All information together with visual representation of activity or specific schedule assist to better and quickly understand the request, which reduces the need for further communication and request clarification, what in the end makes the process more effective. Imagine that you can receive a request for your work area or for your crane where containing all of this information. And this goes for the process of acceptance to different stakeholders, but it is already as a digital data. But a work area is never alone and without a reason. In the real world, one event is usually associated with other events, bringing all information such as temporal change or digital NOTAM on one screen is essential for gaining a complex overview of the airside. A work area, in our case, is accompanied with a crane and a taxiway closure NOTAMs. Now, on the operational level, such a visual reference helps to adjust and plan the activities at the airside to reach better performance, to to not create chaos. But what about mid or long-term planning? Planning of works at the aerodrome is a complex process and focused on the safety that must be done perfectly to avoid a loss of aerodrome efficiency also. All works at the aerodrome are already pending, already approved, but also requested can be visualized for the comparison and evaluation. Finding discrepancies and overlapping of multiple works at the same time can cause longer time for the approval, delays, or can have other more significant impacts. Now, the evaluation of work is not only based on the overlapping, but also on the risk evaluation and possible impact on the traffic and on the safety. The geometry information is one of the crucial parts of our complex AXM data. Based on this information, and additional functions can be used or developed using this information. As for example, the basic one, the distance measurement tool for the measurement of a crane or the work area boundaries, because each feature in the AXM has the exact geometry location, the exact coordinates. So overall, different system Bravo, reading and working with the same data, with the identical data, but serving different purpose and providing different functions. The management of digital data and information offers a great sustainability, evolving dynamic data provided to the end users in the required quality are suitable for long-term and operational usage. And lastly, the complex data containing all vital information can exceptionally support the planning processes and the decision-making process itself. As the ICAO says, the digitization is not an end goal, but the way to achieve the vision. And this is part of the vision: quick, accurate, and effective information and data sharing within the whole aviation industry. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Oliver.
Sorry, very John. I just wanted to say one quick thing, if I may, because I think from an airport operator's perspective, having the tactical, pre-tactical, and strategic information available to you both prior to and post operations becomes something which I think everybody's aspiring to in terms of the long-term operation of airports and managing risk. So from my side, that's where I'll close. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bryan. Sorry about that. I have a couple of questions for you, Oliver, and as I said before, I've got a couple for Gael, but we'll see if we can get through one each and how we go. So Oliver, you mentioned the use of AIXM 5.x as a format. I remember from my days working with EASA that there was quite a bit of pushback from industry for the use of that format in terms of standardizing. Everyone could see the purpose of it, but there was a cost associated with it if you weren't already using it or if you're using an older version. Is that still an issue?
It is really important to understand that if the aviation industry will not move forward towards the digitization, the ATM systems and the whole industry will not bear the traffic growth. That, as Gael said, there is so much notams and so much information today that is unacceptable. So we have to move forward, and the AIXM is the solution, regardless of the costs. And it was developed for this, exactly for this.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. A question for Gael from Marek Jankovic. Do you see this sort of solution as a viable way to improve security in the US?
Yes, thanks. That's a good question. And by the way, just echoing what Oliver just said, please don't publish NOTAMs just for the sake of publishing NOTAMs. Ask you yourself first, is this useful? Is this relevant in terms of air operations? Yeah. Okay, that's very important, because sometimes we see NOTAMs. Why? Why are we publishing all of that, right? So it has to be relevant in terms of operations and safety. Otherwise, it means that it should not be published. And ICAO is doing a lot of campaigning around that messaging right now. And I think it's very, very important for safety, actually, because too much information literally kills situational awareness. And sorry, back to... No, please.
No, just to add on that the no times, which are... has no purpose, which are meaningful, is one thing, but also we see very often NOTAMs in a terrible quality. For example, NOTAMs published for the taxiways that do not exist anymore. The taxiway was closed or removed from the AAP 2 months ago, but the NOTAM is valid right now. So, and here it comes, the lack of information.
I agree. And so to answer the question about security, that's a very good question. And while the ACDM philosophy was not built around security, yes, it does also, it can serve also the purpose of security awareness. Because when you do all that coordination, one of the items that you can include in all the checklists and items that you discuss is, are we touching any security item? Are we sure that collaboratively we are meeting all the standards, but in terms of access control, security gates, and so on, are we good, you know? And you can also trigger through these kind of meetings, you can identify the need for a specific security assessment, for instance. If you realize that you're going to have a big construction project that might need to move temporarily the perimeter fencing, for instance, well, you can raise the flag as part of these strategic or pre-tactical meetings to say, hey, are we all good here in terms of security? So yes, it can be used. It's not the primary purpose of everything I just described, but it can be used also for raising awareness on aviation security issues. Yes, absolutely.
Okay, we'll try one more question, see how we do for time. This is another question from Marek for Gael. Do you know about some activities of the FAA regarding digital NOTAM and data exchange between stakeholders, please?
Yes, I mentioned ACDM. ACDM exists in the United States as well. It's not just in Europe or other parts of the world. It's worldwide. And the FAA with Eurocontrol, along with Eurocontrol, was one of the pioneering CAA in the implementation of collaborative decision making. So you have all of that data exchange and collaborative way to rearrange flights and so on between the airlines and the air traffic control in the US, and the airports are step-by-step joining that process. It's a bit the other way around that what you've seen in Europe, for instance, where it started from the airport, but it's coming to the airport also in the United States. And beyond that, everything that Oliver was talking about, AI, XM, and so on, these are ICAO standards. So yes, it's also something that we have here in the United States, and that flight data providers are benefiting from. You know, the fact that digitalization enables so many things in terms of data management, production and dissemination of the aeronautical information, and repackaging of all of that information. It's something that can be digested by the air crews, because at the end of the day, everything we are doing is for flight operation safety and efficiency, of course, as well. And in digitalization, it's a big step forward in terms of making all of that information accessible in a practical way to the members of the aviation community.
Lovely, thank you. Okay, we've got one more question for Bryan. Bryan, is Neom planning to lead the way within the KSA and the wider region when it comes to digitization of its aeronautical data?
I suppose the answer to that question is we hope so. First mover advantage on this would be depending on who gets there first. Similar to the, not pressure, but the way forward with regards to what's happening in Europe and the USA and other parts of the world, digitization of data is becoming a priority, not just for airports acting by themselves, but for the regulators and the ANSP. So we do see that this is something which will come as a requirement. Back to Oliver's point, it's not whether this will happen, it's when it will happen. And it does improve the overall safety of the ANS system. And so we do see it as a great building block towards a greater safe environment for the aviation sector. And we do hope that we could probably incubate that within NEOM so that it can spread and become a safe a safety contribution to the broader KSA.
Excellent. Thank you very much. So we're out of time for any more questions. I'd like to thank our presenters again, Gael, Bryan, and Oliver, and our sponsors, NG Aviation and Robin Radar Systems. Thank you to all of you for tuning in and having a listen. And don't forget, next Wednesday, we're back at 2:10 on Wednesday afternoon for asset inspection and management. And that will be followed later in the same afternoon by birds and habitat management, both chaired by Mr. Ian Witter. So for now, it's a goodbye from all of us and see you next week. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Stay safe.
Rising air traffic volumes over the last decades puts increasing demands on reliable aeronautical information availability, which is often inaccurate, outdated, inconsistent, faulty, or hard to read, and so undermining the safety of civil aviation. NG Aviation supports the industry by the digitization of various aeronautical information, significantly increasing safety, improving data quality, and enhancing situational awareness. Its digital platform transforms previously scattered aeronautical information into a single comprehensive data source shared among all aviation stakeholders. NG Aviation gives all involved parties the possibility to speak the common language. Our platform significantly improves communication, information, and data exchange. So, for example, if a taxiway must be closed, all involved parties are notified via digital interface. Digital communication allows for clear, more effective, and safer airport operations. Digital data improves communication and navigation through complex airspaces. In case of closure due to military exercise or unexpected circumstances, stakeholders are notified in order to avoid any hazardous situation. The unexpected closure of a runway during the approach is not a problem anymore. Our platform shares the information immediately in a clear and visually understandable way. NG Aviation builds safer and more effective digital aviation of the future. Join the revolution now.
At Moog, we understand how costly foreign object debris can be, which is why we offer the Tarsier Automatic Runway FOD Detection System. In the 11 years since Tarsier was created, it has helped ensure 6 million plus FOD-free operations. It's the United States military's system of choice for FOD detection, and it can function in any and all weather conditions. The difference between Tarsier and manual FOD inspections is easy to see. Tarsier has proven that it detects all the FOD all the time, while manual inspections may miss items due to lighting conditions or the speed of a vehicle inspection. For over 65 years, Moog has been servicing the aircraft industry with innovative products and solutions. With the Tarsier Runway FOD Detection System, we're providing a solution that can generate revenue for your airport, prevent costly airport damage and lawsuits, and improve safety. Contact us.
A powerful solution to the FOD problem, AFOD is an electro-optical detection system supported with artificial intelligence, which is built to prevent the damage to airplanes and airports caused by foreign objects. Thoroughly inspecting airport runways, AFOD provides a constant flow of images and information to a central unit located at the control tower to be further processed by advanced AFOD algorithms. AFOD serves four main functions. By continuously inspecting airport runways, it detects FOD, specifying their location, size, number, and type of material. It also identifies wildlife presence, providing information as detailed as the species of the animal detected. It detects cracks and accumulation areas. It measures the depth of snow and thickness of ice.
The rising air traffic volumes over the last decades puts increasing demands on reliable aeronautical information availability, which is often inaccurate, outdated, inconsistent, faulty, or hard to read, and so undermining the safety of civil aviation. NG Aviation supports the industry by the digitization of various aeronautical information, significantly increasing safety, improving data quality, and enhancing situational awareness. Its digital platform transforms previously scattered aeronautical information into a single comprehensive data source shared among all aviation stakeholders. NG Aviation gives all involved parties the possibility to speak the common language. Our platform significantly improves communication, information, and data exchange. So, for example, if a taxiway must be closed, all involved parties are notified via digital interface. Digital communication allows for clear, more effective, and safer airport operations. Digital data improves communication and navigation through complex airspaces. In case of closure due to military exercise or unexpected circumstances, stakeholders are notified in order to avoid any hazardous situation. The unexpected closure of a runway during the approach is not a problem anymore. Our platform shares the information immediately in a clear and visually understandable way. NG Aviation builds safer and more effective digital aviation of the future. Join the revolution now.